You know, lower taxes sound like a good thing to most people. Some Missouri lawmakers spent the day urging Governor Jay Nixon to approve a tax cut bill.
But the governor is not sure the plan is a good idea. KMBC 9's Michael Mahoney explains.
The bill, in many respects, is a response to the tax cuts that have been enacted in Kansas.
This is the new Prairie Village offices for Central State's capital markets. They're an investment company and so new that they still need a permanent sign for the office. It moved 5 miles from the plaza to Kansas late last year. One of its executives say it wasn't the Kansas tax cuts that lured them, but it was the Kansas incentives that were drawing them over the line.
Tax reforms really were never a consideration. It was really the incentives, and first and foremost, we really liked the area.
Kansas has handed out hundreds of millions to Missouri companies who have made the same move, and about 200 of them have jumped.
There is an element that is a defensive move. But it's not only defensive, it's offensive.
On offense with a tax cut bill. Cuts in the corporate and small business taxes and the first Missouri income tax cut in 90 years.
Those tax cuts could help you stay in business and you're going to create jobs and we want to keep those in Missouri.
But critics say the cuts could hurt the state's ability to pay for things like schools and roads. And even those who have made the switch, like Step, wonder about the real impact of flipping jobs from one side of the state line to another.
It is counterproductive. It creates hard feelings. It divides the economic resources of the community.
Governor Nixon hasn't said whether or not he's going to sign this bill, and the lobbying on both ways, for and against it, is expected to continue for several more weeks. Michael Mahoney, KMBC 9 News. Back to you.
Thank you, Michael. Kansas lawmakers are still in session. They're deadlocked on whether to continue a sales tax extension set to expire this summer.